once we've got them in, we'll stop and have a little chat with each of the drivers in town. Now, I have to go to Louisiana and go to the venue today. His tyres are very expensive, but as you can see, he's a very well-fed and rich young man, so he doesn't need to worry too much about it. Okay, may we have the Highway Patrol in as well, please? From New York, of course, we've got the Highway Patrol from California and the Louisiana State Police. And if that's all there's confusing is about the Italian police services, it all has become as clear as well in a few minutes. This is Bertie, normally well-behaved bear. It has to be said, a very sneaky bear at the best of times. Normally has a tad too much honey, but now just seems to be wandering aimlessly around in his vehicle, without a care in the world, being followed by a police car. We are saddened. You've let the museum down, you've let your country down, but most of all, you've let yourself down. Oh dear, unsteady on feet, smelling of God knows what he's been at. Oh dear, cuffs are going on. Oh, this is a very sad day for Bertie. Not good, is it? All those little children you've let down, taken away in a police car. Well, if we could get you in it. Maybe. Oh no, we can't have pictures of Bertie handcuffed all over YouTube, all over the world. It's going to be a bad day for Brooklands. Give him a big hand to Bertie. A children, he really was only playing. Really thinks of using MG's as police cars, but back some years ago, of course, MG's, Sunbeam Tigers, Daimler Darts, they were all very popular police vehicles because they were very powerful and they could catch the other cars. And we're going to ask a little bit about this beautifully. Is it restored? This car was restored 40 years ago, so I think it really is a testament to the love and attention lavished by the owner on it, that it is here in this remarkable condition. Now, we have, of the two cars you would have seen posted in a lot of 60s, 70s movies, it has to be said, one was from Ford, the Zephyr 6 or the Zodiac, and the other, of course, was the Jaguar, and everybody still loves these, as well as the police ones. A little bit along, and we'll bring up. Well, if you watch the Sweeney and that kind of thing, you will be very familiar with some of these particular vehicles. From a 3.5 litre, we all remember, not the SD1, the one before, sometimes in S version with the wheel on the back. This is awesome. And you may know as well the 3.5 litre Rover, of course.
Okay, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. What you're seeing in front of you here is what's known as a routine traffic stop. We have a potentially well-known villain in his Volkswagen. It's just being pulled over now by one of the officers from Surrey Police. One of the things they're going to be looking for now is proof of documentation that he is correctly insured, making sure the vehicle is fully roadworthy and should be on the road. It's not looking good for this gentleman. As you can see, he's a pretty shady looking character. He's also the chairman of the Institute of Vehicle Recovery, so he won't hold that against him. Unfortunately, it's not looking good at all. It turns out that this vehicle is uninsured. He's chosen not to pay his premiums. So as a result, the vehicle is going to be seized under section 165 of the Road Traffic Act. What we've got here is a Scania 6x2 heavy slide bed vehicle. Yes, and our gentleman here is having a particularly bad day now. He's just realised that he's going to be walking home. At least the weather's nice for you, eh? Oh, he's got a ticket as well. Okay, so For those that don't know, Section 165, potentially you can have up to, I think, 6 points on your licence as a result. So yeah, it's been a particularly bad day for you. So what you can see here now, the Scania vehicle is sliding the slide bed part of the truck off. So then the guys can then winch the car up onto the bed. Two guys that we've got working here from our team are Paul and Dan. They've both been with us close to a year now. The other bit of equipment they're also trained to use is the lorry loader crane, which we talked about earlier on. So they actually work through different scenarios using the crane to lift vehicles that hold various different conditions.
Thank you. Give a big hand, ladies and gentlemen, McAllister's Recovery. Great supporters of this event. So I'm sure you don't want to have to use them, but if you do, they are one very good firm. There's certainly people in a long time to be recovered from. And a thank you, as always, to Surrey Police stepping into the breach.
Right.